Good evening, everyone, and a warm season's greetings to you. My name is Lee Savalixic, and I am the Executive Director of Pittsburgh Youth Chorus. For over 35 years, PYC has been a community in which young musicians from the Pittsburgh region could create bonds with one another and experience the joy and power of using their voice. Last March, that was all turned on its head when we lost the ability to gather with one another. However, despite the limitations, our staff and board were determined to continue serving our young singers and offering the life-giving gift of music to our greater community. In an ongoing effort to adapt and meet our singers where they are, we transformed our rehearsals, our program offerings, and our audition process to accommodate our quarantined reality. When the parent of a singer asked us if we would broadcast last year's winter concert on the date that it would have been this year, we knew that the shared experience of a concert was still something of value and importance, even at a distance. When we decided to move forward with this project, we did what PYC aims to do with all our endeavors, which is to broaden the circle. We involved the former conductors of Children's Festival Chorus, the name under which PYC was founded. Over the next hour, you will hear hand-selected performances made by our conductors, past and present, and they will also share stories about why these selections stood out in their memory. Before we begin with the music, I want to take a moment and thank those of you who made a donation to support this program. Many of you watching also indicated a willingness to make a gift sometime this evening. To do that, you can visit pittsburghyouthchorus.org/donate or use the link in the video description below. Thank you again for your support. We will begin with a carol that has become a traditional opener for the PYC Winter Concert. Here's Once in Royal David City, sung by the combined choirs with soloist Liam McCarthy.
Mary, Lord, Thank you for joining us for this very special concert. My name is Angela Evans, and I'm the conductor of the Troubadour Choir. I have been working with the Troubadour since the 2010-2011 season. The selection that I've chosen for today's concert is The Friendly Beasts from the 2015 Winter Concert. I love the Winter Concert because it is the first time that the Troubadours often have an opportunity to sing with all of the choirs of the Pittsburgh Youth Chorus. And something so magical happens when my students get to hear the voices of the older children and interact with the other conductors. So I've chosen this piece first because it's a full group piece. And I remember the feeling that I had when my children started to sing this along with the other choirs. I also love this piece because it talks about the simple gifts that were given around the holiday season. And I love talking with the students about how the simple gifts that we have inside of all of us really make not only the holidays, but every day very special. I hope you enjoy this recording and that your holidays are filled with light, love, and happiness.
Around. Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us for the virtual winter archival concert from CFC and PYC. I'm Sean Funk, and I currently serve as the artistic director. I have served in a variety of roles in this organization, from a teacher referring students, as an accompanist, as a parent, as a camp POD. And so I've sort of been through the ground up. And in 2013, I was invited to conduct the Talisman Choir, leading to an interim artistic director appointment in 2014, and was asked to stay on in 2015. I find myself with a wonderful team of professionals and am enjoying my work as we move forward with our mission. I want to talk a bit about the piece that I chose from the archives, which is a South African folk song called Hambanati. I was taught this song by Nick Page, who the choral world knows as the folk song sing-along giant that he is, as well as a skilled choral arranger. Once I learned it from Nick, I knew I had to teach it to Pittsburgh Youth Chorus. And it's a song that really stems to the apartheid in South Africa. And loosely translated, it talks about, walk with us for the road is long. Come to the table and share our bread. We're going to get through this together. And how appropriate I felt to bring that in. It also features one of our illustrious alums, George Milosh, who serendipitously, we met it and planned this without any prior connection, but we were doing the Macmillan Gloria with Resonance Works, and it's a world premiere, and I knew there was a very difficult tenor solo, and when we walked into the rehearsal, I heard this wonderful voice. Lo and behold, it's a CFC alum, George Milosh, and so we started to plan for this event at that time. You'll notice the kids love the piece. They're walking along, has a lot of energy, and I think it will lift our spirits and send a message, so I hope you enjoy Hambanati.
Hambanati.
PYC Talisman Choir. As a way of sharing during the concert, we would encourage you to take a picture of you and your family watching the concert. At the end of the concert, I will tell you how to share the picture with us so that we can post it on our social medias. Thank you. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Hi, I am Steve Schmidt, and I conduct the Talisman Choir. I've been with Pittsburgh Youth Chorus since 2013, and currently in that role. And I just want to wish everybody a happy holiday, no matter what holiday you're celebrating right now. There's so many wonderful holidays, and the beautiful thing about this time of year is just being together with your family and being able to celebrate the wonderful bond that you have with everyone, no matter what holiday you do celebrate. So, happy holidays. The piece that I selected for our concert today is called Honorot Hallelu, and it is a traditional Hebrew hymn, actually. And in doing a lot of research for this song, when we did it back in 2015, when I performed it with the Talisman Choir, it is a hymn that was customary to recite after lighting the Hanukkah candles at the table every night with your family, which I did not know prior to doing this piece. So I thought that was really interesting that Jewish people would get together and sit around the table and light the menorah. And then they would sing some traditional Hanukkah style hymns like Honorot Hallelu. And this translation of the piece is basically, we light these candles to commemorate the saving acts and miracles and wonders that have been performed. So if you know anything about the story of Hanukkah, you know that the miracle of the oil burning for 8 days and eight nights after the fight between the Maccabees and King Epiphanes and his army. And so it's a really wonderful time for Jewish people to be able to sit down and celebrate together of that miracle that occurred. And I picked that piece. I love Hebrew music. I think there's so much value in teaching it, but there's just also a lot of beauty in it as well. So I hope you enjoyed the piece. I know when we did it in 2015, my students really loved it due to the language and how difficult it was to learn Hebrew, as well as some of the tempo changes were very fun for them. So I hope you enjoy Honorot Hallelu as much as we enjoyed it.
Thank you. everybody. Happy holidays. My name is Amy Cagle, and I am the conductor of the Grove City Satellite Choir of the Pittsburgh Youth Chorus. This program started in 2016, and it was the vision of Sean Funk to reach out to students in West Central Pennsylvania and really give them the PYC experience that's been enjoyed in our city for so long. And though I've only been conducting with the group since 2016, I have been a fan and big supporter of the group for years. I first heard Children's Festival Chorus back in the 1980s when they were performing with the Pittsburgh Symphony. That was my first view and hearing of them. And I became so attached to the group and the beautiful sound they made. And over the years of teaching in the public school system, I sent many, many students into Children's Festival Chorus to be part of that program. I've also had two nephews and a niece be part of it, and just recently my own daughter. So tonight, I have selected my favorite piece performed by the Grove City Satellite Choir. It's called Niño Precioso. It was written by Rosephanie Powell, who is an American composer and a fantastic arranger. So she arranged this Nicaraguan lullaby, and you will hear the children singing it in Spanish. I chose it for its beautiful harmonies, lilting rhythms, and you'll also hear a nice little percussion section accompanying them. I hope you enjoy this performance of Niño Precioso.
Thank you for watching, everyone. I'm Elaine Goldsmith. I was on the conducting staff for CFC for 20 years, beginning in 1990. And during that time, I led every level of choir, except for the most advanced choir, which was led by Christine Jordanoff, our artistic director. Probably the last two-thirds of my time was with the Talisman Choir. I think one of the most vivid memories I have was in the fall of 2004, and the Pittsburgh Symphony wanted a CFC group for two separate concert programs in December, within a couple of weeks of each other, one with 11 performances and one with 3 performances. And even though the Bel Cantos were always the designated choir for PSO collaborations, they couldn't do both programs in addition to our own December concert. That was just too much. So it was decided that the Talisman Choir would take the program of 3 performances on stage at Heinz Hall with the PSO conducted by James Conlon. Since Christine had built the CFC reputation as the go-to children's choir for professional collaboration, the PSO trusted that any group of children whom CFC sent would deliver a performance to the expected standard. Needless to say, I felt the weight of this responsibility, and I made sure the choir did too. I still have the email I sent them, as well as some of their responses. There were so many experiences packed into that one weekend that went beyond the actual singing. It was very rewarding to watch them take responsibility for their contribution. As a group, they had to stand and seat themselves without any direction, without listening intently for the musical cues that we had determined ahead of time, and then have the courage to do it. Giving those young singers the experience of singing on a world-class stage with a world-class orchestra and conductor is one of the more extraordinary aspects of what CFC gave to its members and the community. A couple of pieces from when Sean Funk's daughter, Rebecca, was a Talisman singer came to mind immediately. So I reached out to Rebecca to see what she remembered, and it was Winter's Night. This is a perfect piece to choose because, first of all, I remember this choir being such a great combination of beautiful voices and openness and hunger for learning. And we collaborated with two fabulous musicians and human beings, Chris Benham on piano and Heidi Pandolfi on oboe, both of whom have daughters who also were in CFC. And Winter's Night is unique in that it's sung without any meaningful text, so there's no message to be communicated. We had to create an environment of cold, snowy, windy, desolate darkness that was where an entire culture of people live in the north of Norway. So there was a little bit of an anthropology lesson inserted into the choral rehearsal. And we added an extra sound effect at the end to give a little more chill to the room. So enjoy Winter's Night. Thank you.
Hi there. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Lisa Jaworski, and I was a conductor with CFC PYC for 17 years, conducting both the Troubadours and the Talisman. So I just want to say to you, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. I hope your holidays are wonderful, and we are so glad that you're joining us for this event. So in all of those years with the organization, one of the memories that stands out the most to me is the year that we did a concert with the New York Voices. And the four New York Voices came to Duquesne. They workshopped with our students in all three choirs. And then each of the members of the New York Voices worked specifically with the Bel Canto and the Talisman and the Troubadours. And that was the year that I got to meet Mrs. Kim Nazarian Ashby. And Kim worked with the Troubadours, learning a piece called Old MacDoodle Had a Farm. And then the New York Voices performed at that concert. We were at Carnegie Music Hall in Oakland for that performance. And I will never, ever forget that experience. It was, I believe, in 1998 or 1999. It opened my eyes and my ears to the world of choral music and how it can connect to jazz. And really that leads up to why Jingle Bell Swing was the piece that I chose to share in this concert presentation. Because of the experience with the New York Voices, I began to study jazz. And doing that piece, that swing style piece with those students that year in the Talisman was so much fun, and it began to open a whole new world for them. So I think that's why I love the piece so much, Jingle Bell Swing. It just really opened the door for the students, and I do hope that you really enjoy their performance. It was a wonderful, wonderful concert at East Liberty Presbyterian Church that year.
Jingle bells, 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 jingle bells Hello, everybody. My name is Jane Panzella, and I was fortunate to conduct the Talisman Group of the Pittsburgh Youth Chorus, which was initially called the Children's Festival Chorus, from the fall of 1985 until the spring of 1998. It was a wonderful experience to work with hundreds of amazing young singers at that time. One of my favorite pieces to conduct at the winter concert in 1996 was an arrangement by the well-known conductor Robert Page, who had worked with the chorus for quite a while in different occasions, of the song Bless the Beasts and the Children. And there were several reasons that I chose this song to conduct. The kids were familiar with the music through the musical and the movie, and they liked the song. And of course, all kids like animals, and many of them have pets, and they're concerned about how they're protected, along with the animals and the, we'll call them beasts, from the other parts of the world. I always thought this piece was kind of a prayer to be sung, bless the beasts and the children. And besides blessing the beasts themselves, the children were at the age they were going to become adults in a very formative journey. And they will all face situations where there are many different changes and opportunities and diverse situations in the world to be accompanied, that needed to be accompanied by protectiveness and safeness and caring and love. So as I was conducting them, I kind of said my little silent prayer along with them in Bless the Beasts and the Children. I hope you enjoy the recording that was made in the winter concert in 1996. It was a joy to sing with them. Thank you for listening. Thank you.
Greetings, everyone, and happy holidays. My name is Ann Leineberger, and I've served on the board of the Pittsburgh Youth Chorus for a number of years. This is my second season as board president. To me, the power of PYC's programming has always been the joy I see on the faces of our kids as they perform, and the joy I see on the faces of the people who are listening. As a lifelong singer myself, I'm passionate about the fact that we're delivering to our kids programming that trains them at a high level to have the skill to take singing and their love of singing into adulthood. I'm so proud of our staff, our families, and our singers for meeting the challenge of the pandemic with dedication and with that continued sense of joy in the act of singing. PYC's organizational family has been growing in recent years, and our board and staff have a vision of PYC that is inclusive of Pittsburgh's diverse neighborhoods and communities. The next selection is an indication of that growing family. This time last year, PYC invited young singers from our various neighborhood training choir programs to join the other choirs at East Liberty Presbyterian Church for our 2019 winter concert. The medley of wintertime favorites you're about to hear featured nearly 200 young singers, a record number of PYC participants to take the stage at one time. This arrangement of It's Snowing is a gold standard, and many PYC alums will remember learning it with Mrs. Goldsmith. We featured it to showcase the neighborhood training choirs as they made their winter concert debut. Thank you for supporting the important mission of Pittsburgh Youth Chorus and for joining us this evening. And now enjoy this performance of It's Snowing.
It's snowing, it's snowing. Hey, look, it's snowing.
Snow is falling.
It's time for Merry Christmas and happy holidays to all of you. My name is Christine Jordanoff, and I had the privilege of being the artistic director of the Children's Festival Chorus, now Pittsburgh Youth Chorus, from 1986 until 2014. The piece you're about to hear is called Untraveled Worlds, and it's by Paul Halley. This piece epitomized who we were as a children's chorus at the time it was selected for performance. The text of this piece in particular was meaningful because it showed who we were. It showed my philosophy of life. Untraveled worlds, keep going where you haven't been. Experience life in every new way. It's the breath of life, the spirit of life that keeps us going, learning as much as we can. The Children's Festival Chorus was founded on the principles of choral education through quality performance. I can remember one very special time, among many actually, when we were chosen through blind audition to sing at the Music Educators National Conference in Cincinnati. This was a conference in front of my professional colleagues. We had an audience of about 1,600 people crammed into the auditorium. The scary part of it for me was that there would be a workshop before our concert and a different clinician would be working with our children in front of all of these unknown 1,600 people. The children responded so beautifully. The purpose of the concert was multicultural understanding. And I think we sang probably in 6 or 7 different languages in that concert. But the clinician wanted to know, did the children really know anything about this music, or were they just trained to repeat it by rote? Well, our kids, to use the expression, knocked their socks off because they not only understood the music, but they could relate it to events that were happening in their own lives, current events, family events, personal events. When we sang our concert, after it was over, the audience rose to its feet, and I don't know how many encores we had. They just would not stop clapping. And it was a moment of such pride and gratification, not only for me, but for the children as well, because they needed to see that they weren't just this little group in Pittsburgh, that they were out there and what they were doing was appreciated by people from all over the country. One of the very special aspects about the particular performance that you're going to hear is that the orchestra which accompanied us was comprised of some parents of the organization and some of my students at Duquesne University, where we were in residence for many years. This was so exciting because it was the cooperation, the bonding that took place between the adults, the musicians, and our young singers. Very, very, very satisfying, wonderful experience. And on that note, I will wish you again a very, very happy holiday and hope that you enjoy our performance of Untraveled Worlds by Paul Halley. Thank you.
For our final selection, we'd like to share our second ever virtual choir video, an arrangement of Winter Wonderland by Andy Beck. It's been a novel treat to put these projects together, and you can expect to see more virtual choir videos from PYC in the future. I'd especially like to thank David Fedor for his video editing work on this project. I hope you enjoy the video, and I wish you a safe and joyful holiday season.
Archival Winter Concert. If you did take a picture, then please make sure to post it on social media and tag Pittsburgh Youth Chorus so that we can repost it. Stay tuned for other exciting PYC projects, performances, and other opportunities for alums. If you know someone who'd like to sing with us, tell them about our information session on January 5th about mid-season enrollment. You'll find the registration link for this in the chat. Thank you for watching and have a happy holidays.